It's time for the dual screen ultimate comparison. Stay tuned.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video we are going to do a comparison between the two Duocade arcade machines from our friend from China, or the official Pandora Box store. I don't know if you've seen both reviews, but you need to check them out, because this video is just basically more like a side by side and quick comparison video. And if you're thinking of buying one of these products, maybe I can help you out decide which one will fit your need. I like to point out both of these systems are just powered with the Pandora Box number 6. The real deal, not the fake shit you can buy that had a lot of crappy games. I did a lot of reviews about them, check it out. I have one big Pandora family list of products that you can find all the information you need. But right, nevertheless, in this video we're going to focus on these cabinets. What are the differences? And there will be some Captain Obvious moments, I know, but I want to talk about, let's say, everything. So you have a very good idea what you're going to get. Okay, so let's talk about the DIY version of the dual screened Pandora boxes. So the first thing that is in Captain Obvious moment, it's in DIY. So in other words, you need to build it yourself. Keep in mind there is no soldering required. And the Pandora box is pretty damn self-explaining, so it's just plug and play. But keep in mind you need to be a little bit handy, you don't need an extra screwdriver. I recommend it because the screwdriver comes with this kit is pretty damn horrible. But I think the most important thing is, what do you need? A little bit of technical background, because you need to know what you're doing. And a lot of patience with this thing, because it's not a very easy pack to build together. But it's a lot of fun, so that's pretty damn cool. Alright, so let's talk about the Mini Arcade Pandora Box, or in other words, the Neo Geo dual screen look-alike. This thing is made fully of plastic. This is not a DIY, so in other words, you can just pull it out of the box, plug in the power supply, and you can play some arcade games. It's really self-explaining, this thing. And the only thing you need to do, of course, is add your own games. Keep that in mind. But beside that, there's no assembly required. So for the people who just want to have this thing plug and play ready, this is maybe a better way for you. And again, it's made from plastic, so this thing weighs almost nothing. Got a very cheap feel to it. And in this part of the video, we are going to do a side-by-side comparison with the control panel over the buttons. I just wanted to give you a quick look, what are the differences and what are we going to get with the cabinets. Okay, so let's talk about the first cabinet, the Wood Edition DIY pack. What I've noticed with this, and this is something you don't see very often with these cabinets, we're going to get some lighter buttons. I think that is pretty damn awesome, and it's something, again, that you don't see very often. So yeah, this is what we're going to get. The joystick itself, it's more like a clone of the Senua, not bad at all. Got a very nice response. And the buttons, yeah, what can you expect for the money? They're just Chinese buttons. Yeah, with light up. Alright, so let's take a close look at the Neo Geo dual screen version. This one doesn't come with lighter buttons, just white buttons, nothing special. The buttons itself are not to compare with Senua, they're having a very nice touchpad. Response is good, but nothing beats an original Senua button. The joystick, same like the other version. I must say that for a cheaper system, I really like this joystick. It's personally a little bit better than the wooden edition. In this part of the video, we are going to do a side-by-side comparison with the LCD screens are included in these cabinets. And we're going to see, are the differences here? Because for the first cabinet, we are going to talk about the DIY Wood Edition again. So in this version, we're having some plexiglass in front of the LCD displays. I don't know if you would need to be very happy with it. I like the finish touch, don't get me wrong. But what I think is a big problem, don't forget, this is going to get some scratches in the future. So it's very scratch sensitive, and it can become a little bit of filth between the screen and the acrylic itself. So I don't know if you need to be a big fan of it. I like the finishing touch, it looks very nice. And it got some awesome little bezel around it. Pretty damn cool. Really love to know what you think of this. Alright, so the Neo Geo, this is a little bit of a different story. First of all, I think this is my version I have here, but mine got two different screens. One with a glossy and one with a matte finish. So that is a little bit of an epic feel. But yeah, nothing to do about it. It's what it is. And but yeah, with this version you can basically touch the screen. If it's the basic, let's say if the matte finish is the normal screen that goes into this machine, it's not a big problem. Because a matte finish is not that sensitive to scratches. If it's going to be the glossy one, you don't need to be happy with it. You can clean it very easily. There is no acrylic front of it. It doesn't give this more luxury feeling to it, but this is what you're going to get. All right, a quick side-by-side comparison. Maybe you've already seen it in the overview. You can see with the Neo Geo version, the plastic version, that we're having less quality screens. The view angle is not that great, like the wooden version. And here the side-by-side, maybe you can see a little bit of the difference between the screens. Okay, so if you're talking about the main board, both of the systems have the official Pandora box number 6. I have noticed there are some sellers selling one of these cabinets with Pandora box 9D or 9 or another weird knockoff version. So if you look at the differences, you can pull it out from the system itself because this is a DIY package. So that's pretty damn neat. Why? I really don't know why you should even do this. If you can upgrade it in the future, that's something we need to see because the way how the thing is connected. We're having the holes, and if they are swapping something out, let's say the USB connectors, you're having this problem, you can't upgrade it. With the Neo Geo version or the fake, I can make up so many names on this thing, but nevertheless, the cheaper edition, the plastic version, I can keep going with this. You cannot even pull it out. You need to open it at the bottom and you just need to pull it out. If you can upgrade it, same story like the wooden edition, I have really no clue. If to swap out the connections, you have a problem. All right, so both systems have exactly the same little speaker. It's more like something like a 5 watts mono speaker. Both are pretty damn loud. I can tell you that already, but this is what you're going to get. I think this is exactly the same speaker that they're using inside this Pandora case itself. So it's all the same people, all the same. All right, so in this part, we are going to do a little bit of side-by-side comparison. It's going to be a Captain Obvious moment, but still, I just wanted to show you in this video because we're going to do a marquee comparison. Let's start with the wood edition. So what is really cool about this cabinet, I'm just going to say it, it's cool with the light up. I personally like it. And also it comes with an RGB marquee lit up. The effect of it, because it's more like an acrylic, and there behind it we have this piece of, yeah, I wouldn't say paper, but this thin sticker. So having this very cool effect of the RGB strip that is behind it. So that's pretty damn cool. I think there's a very big positive side of this thing, and the effect is amazing. And if you don't like it, you can just pull out the cable and you don't have a light marquee. Okay, the Neo Geo version. And I already said at the beginning of this video, this is more like a cheap version, and you can see it here in the marquee. It's basically just a sticker. It's a sticker that they just slapped in this thing. It's a little bit of a bummer, to be honest. It does not look very bad, or no, not at all, but I just wanted to give you this overview and show what you're going to get. So if you like more light up marquees, this isn't going to be a big bummer for you because this cheap version doesn't have even the option for it. All right, so to conclude this video, both of the systems have the pros and the cons. For example, the wood edition, I really like it. It's a very nice product, only you need to build it yourself. So if you're not handy or you don't have the patience for it or the time, you have a problem. So this is not really an option for you. On the other hand, the plastic version, the Neo Geo clone, is made from plastic. Gets a cheap feel, it's ready to go, plug and play. You don't need to build anything. But it is cheaper made. You can see it in many things. For example, the screens, the way how it's the build quality. The funny thing is that the joystick is a little bit better, but nevertheless, you can always swap them out if you want. So this is what you're going to get. This is the side-by-side comparison. I hope you have a better idea. If you have any questions, you can all leave it in the comments. Well, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the little bell. And if you're into gaming, you can always check the Wicked Gaming channel for more awesome Wicked gaming content. See you next time. Bye-bye.
It's time for the...
Ow.
Ow!
Oh,